2019, 8:47 a.m. Pacific time. Hope you're doing well. This is Memorial Day weekend 2019, and I just want to start off by thanking and honoring all those who have given their life in the service of our country in war, and we are eternally grateful for your sacrifice that you have given yourself for our country, and for every soldier that goes into the military, that's your commitment, I believe. And so thank you to all of our military, all of our soldiers, and we pray right now for the families that have lost loved ones in war. We pray for you to comfort them, Lord. All the Gold Star mothers and fathers and families, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And Lord, thank you for our freedom. Thank you for this country, Lord. Thank you, God Almighty, for the land of the free and the home of the brave. Gets more precious every single year, every day that we have our country. It's more and more precious. And thank you so much, Lord. I'm going to get over here into the Psalms. Thank you, Lord. Let me see. Psalm 126. When the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter. Lord, we thank you for this day and your word, and for you, God, for your Holy Spirit, for Jesus. Thank you, God Almighty. Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord hath done great things for them. The Lord hath done great things for us, whereof we are glad. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. We'll just continue on to Psalm 127. Just take it all in. Just allow God to refresh your brain, refresh your mind, refresh your soul by his word. Except the Lord build the house, Psalm 127, except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waketh, but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. Lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. This is King James Version, public domain. As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are children of the youth. Father, bless and touch and protect the children, even the unborn. God, all, even the teenagers, Lord, in Jesus' name, the young people and the old people too, Lord, touch and bless and have mercy and give us all health. Happy is the man that has his quiver full of them, children. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate. Something about children are kind of a protectorate against the evil of the enemy. And Satan, I bind you right now from all of our lives, our precious loved ones, families, loved ones, children, all the churches, all the synagogues, all the mosques. Father, we come against the hate right now in this country and in this world. We come against the KKK and the white supremacists. We come against white nationalism. That's not the same as nationalism. Do your homework, okay? We come against Antifa, of the hatred of Antifa, the violence right now. And I'm not saying they've done any violence lately, but I'm just praying about some of this stuff right now. Take authority over terrorism in the name of Jesus in any form. we come against any kind of shootings right now in any fashion from anybody. Shootings, Lord God, whatever's going on in people's brains, hearts, minds, whatever they have been offended by, whatever the deep hurt that might be smoldering in their hearts and minds, Lord, that they want to take out their hurt and their hatred on somebody, some innocent people. Father, I pray for healing, Lord God, for these people, that you would lessen their pain so that they don't feel and their hatred in their heart where they target somebody that has nothing to do. Help people calm down, Lord. And I don't know why I went into that, but let's get back onto the word, okay? This is deep prayer. This is intercessory prayer, and that's what I am. And so when you watch these videos, this is what I do, okay? Don't be alarmed by it. If more people would get into doing it this way, praying for our country and our world, believe me, God answers prayer. Psalm 128. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways, that honor the Lord, that know that there is a God, know that he's powerful, know that we need his mercy. I mean, we ask God for his mercy, and we need his blessings in our lives and on our country and in our world. Okay? Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways, and he's a good God. You don't have to fear him like he's, oh, he hates you and he's an evil God. No, he's a good God, okay? That's why he's a God of love, okay? He wants you to be safe. He wants you to be healthy and healed. If you aren't healthy, he wants you to be healthy and healed. He wants every need supplied, okay? For thou shalt eat the labor of thine hands. Happy shalt thou be. Let's start over. Psalm 128. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways. For thou shalt eat the labor of thine hands, happy shalt thou be, and it shall be well with thee. Lord, we claim these words. We claim these words for every one of us that feareth you, Lord, that walk in your ways, that try our hardest to walk in your ways, not to the letter of the law that kills, but knowing that we are weak, but when we are weak, you are strong. You make up the difference. So, Lord, we thank you for these words. It shall be well with thee. Thy wife shall be as a fruitful vine by the sides of thine house, thy children like olive plants round about thy table. Behold, that thus shall the man be blessed that feareth the Lord. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion, and thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. Yea, thou shalt see thy children's children, and peace upon Israel. Thank you, Lord God. Praise your holy name. Psalm 129. Many a time have they afflicted me from my youth, may Israel now say. Many a time have they afflicted me from my youth, yet they have not prevailed against me. The plowers plowed upon my back, they made long their furrows. The Lord is righteous, he hath cut asunder the cords of the wicked. Let them all be confounded and turned back that hate Zion. Let them be as the grass upon the housetops, which withereth afore it groweth up, wherewith the mower filleth not his hand, nor he that bindeth sheaves his bosom, neither do they which go by say, the blessing of the Lord be upon you. We bless you in the name of the Lord. And thank you so much, Lord God, for this word here. Pray it bless our day and bless the people out there in the world and in our country, that you'll keep everybody safe on this Memorial Day weekend, and bless and touch all the churches and the pastors and the congregations, Lord. Touch the Catholic Church, the Protestant Church, the Jews, Father God Almighty, hope. Open their hearts to Jesus. Open their hearts to consider that he might just be who he says he is, who your word says he is, Lord, the New Testament. And I thank you for that, Lord. Open their hearts. Just open their hearts to the possibility that it could be true and draw people to Jesus, Father. Thank you for this day, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a really good day, everybody, and God bless. God bless. I love you. Bye-bye.